I am Dr. Mahesh Batane, working as assistant professor, and I will teach you the subject of physics of thin film for your second year MSc. Okay, so this is very fundamental and very interesting subject. Okay, thin film or physics of thin film, which is very much interesting if you are interested to do research in the area of material science, solid state physics, nanotechnology and nanomaterials, so that this subject or the concept of this subject are very much useful. Okay, so in this subject there are total number of module is 4. Okay, so there are total number of module is 4, and the first module is introduction of thin film. Okay, so recently or currently we will start to teach you, that is introduction to thin films. Okay, second module is deposition techniques and measurement of thickness. Okay, and after complete or after the finishing of these two modules, so we will start our next two modules. Okay, so I will only focus on the chapter of introduction to solid. Okay, so that in this chapter I will explain you the fundamental concept of overview of vacuum technology. Okay, so during the preparation of thin film, during the synthesis of thin film, or during the making of thin film, which kind of technology or which kind of process are required, or which techniques are very much useful during the preparation of thin film, so that there is some required vacuum technology, there is required some of the vacuum technique. Okay, so that we will try to discuss about the overview of vacuum techniques. Okay, later on comparison of thin and thick film. Okay, later on we will discuss about the topic of comparison of thin and thick films. Okay, it means that in that concept or in that topic we will try to discuss about the thin and thick. What is the difference between the thin and thick films? Okay, how small are thin and how large are thick? Okay, thin means how smallest size are available, or how smallest size are occupied, or we can say that what is the minimum width of thin film. We can say that is a thin film. Okay, and beyond the size of particular range, which size is nothing but a thick films. Okay, and which film we can not say that is not a thin film. Okay, so we will discuss that comparison. After that we will move towards the theory of growth or theory of growth of thin films. Okay, and inside that we will try to focus on nucleation, condensation, capillary model, atomistic model, comparison of models and various stage of film growth. Okay, so currently we only focus on the topic of introduction to thin films. Okay, this chapter is covered this type of topics. Okay, and the given credit is 1 for that particular chapter. Okay, so that let us start the topic of thin film. Okay, generally we will talk on the topic of overview of vacuum techniques, but you should keep in your mind that how thin film is look like. Okay, you should keep in your mind that what is mean by thin film, how it's behave like, and how it's obtained, or we can say that how it's look like, what is the dimension of thin film. Okay, how was its behavior? Okay, and what is the size of thin film exactly? Okay, so discuss about that. So look at in first point, or look at into the first figure, that is this figure. Okay, so this figure indicates that the ranges of the matter, okay, and this is the LHS side, left hand side, and this is your RHS side, that is nothing but a right hand side. Okay, so LHS is nothing but a higher size particle or higher size of object. Okay, and left hand side image or left hand side of objects indicates a lower size or very less size of object. Okay, so here this particular figure indicates a acrylic board, brass board. Okay, acrylic brass board. Okay, and if you keep this acrylic brass board in your hand, so you can easily obtain, or if you easily look it onto that brass board, so you can say that the size of that particular brass board is around some of the micrometer. Okay, because you can easily obtain the thickness of that particular brass board. Okay, means the thickness of that particular brass board is around 1000 of micrometer. Okay, so you already aware that how to calculate the size, or how to obtain, or how to measure the size if the size is less than centimeter. Okay, you are a MSc student, so I am not talking about the size of the matter. Okay, I am talking about the size of the films. Okay, because you already aware what it mean by kilometer, what it mean by megameter, what it mean by centimeter, what it mean by meter. Okay, that is all about the dimension. Okay, and if this size is below less than centimeter, that is 10^-2 meter, that is nothing but a centimeter, which we can easily measure by using the scale. Okay, but beyond less than that particular size, that is centimeter or 1 centimeter, so we need a vernier calipers to measure a millimeter size. Okay, or to measure a micrometer size purposes, we have to take a screw gauge. Okay, millimeter or micrometer size we can easily measure by using the vernier calipers or micrometer screw gauge. Or if suppose that this size is less than 1000 micrometer, for that purpose we have to look, or we have to use a optical microscope. Getting my point? For that purpose we have to take, or we have to use a optical microscope. And if we use an optical microscope, so we can easily determine, or we can easily obtain the size of micrometer size. Okay, and beyond less than that micrometer size, if the size is around in terms of 10 micrometer or 1 micrometer or several hundred nanometers, around you can say that 1000 nanometer, 500 nanometer, and for that purpose we have to use some kind of special kind of instrument, that is scanning electron microscope, transmission electron microscope, or field emission scanning electron microscope. Getting my point? So that if the particular thickness of that brass board is around 100 micrometer, so that thickness we can measure by using the screw gauge. Okay, but in the second figure, that is the thick film which is size is around 100 micrometer. Okay, so for that purpose we have to use a optical microscope or some kind of other instrument. Getting my point? Okay. So if we draw the line here, okay, so this area indicates a thick area. Okay, this area indicates a thick area, or we can say that the size of is around or in terms of micron size. Okay, or less than 1 micrometer. Okay, you have to aware that the size, or you have to aware that the conversion factor of dimension of the meter. Okay, if I ask you some kind of question like 1 micrometer means how much nanometer, so you should aware, you have to know that size. Okay, so that 1 micrometer is nothing but a 1000 of nanometer. Okay, 1 micrometer is around 1000 of nanometer, and here is the thin film. Okay, here is the thin film. I can write here in short form, that is capital T and capital F. That is nothing but a thin film. Okay, and this is not a thin film. This part is not a thin film. Okay, this term indicates a substrate. This is your substrate. Okay, and these are the atoms. These are the atoms. This is number 1 atom. This is number 2 atom. These are the number 3 atom, number 4 atoms, number 5th atom, or millions of atoms which is deposited onto that particular substrate. Okay, number of atoms, number of molecules, number of elements are deposited onto that particular substrate, and the layer was occupied, or there some layer was present, or we can say that the layer was formed, and that layer is nothing but a thin film. Getting my point? That layer is nothing but a thin film. Okay, and the size of that particular thin layer is nothing but a less than 1 micrometer, or nothing but a 0.1 micrometer. Okay, or 0.001 micrometer size. Getting my point? What is the range of thin film? I am not talking about a thick film. I am talking about a thin film. What is the size of thin film? That is the less than 0.1 micrometer to around 0.01 micrometer. Okay, keep in your mind, 1 micrometer is equal to 1000 of nanometer. 0.1 micrometer means 100 nanometer, and 0.01 nanometer means 10 nanometer. So the size of that particular thin film is around 10 nanometer, or we can say that 1 nanometer to 100 nanometer, and that range of that thin film is nothing but a size of the film, or size of that particular film. Getting my point? So the range of that particular thin film, or thickness of that particular thin film, is around, or approximately around, a 100 nanometer to, or we can say that 10 nanometer to several number of micrometers, or one we can say that near about less than 10 micrometer. Okay, or we can, this is the 10 micrometer, or below less than 10 micrometer, below less than 10 micrometer, or about 10 or about 10 nanometer. That range is occupied, or that range is the thickness of that particular thin film. Getting my point? Now last figure indicates a atoms, or size of the atom, or size of the molecules. Okay, so size of the atoms is around 1 angstrom. Size of the atom is around 1 angstrom, or nothing but a 10 angstrom. Okay, 0.001 micrometer is nothing but a 0.001 micrometer is nothing but a 10 angstrom, which is the size of atoms or molecules. Okay, 1 angstrom or less than that. Okay, so that in our present subject we will focus on this area only. Which area? This area. Okay, this area only. We will try to focus on that particular area, that is the thin film area. Okay, now look into this figure. Okay, So this figure indicates this is your substrate. Green portion indicates a substrate. That is, A portion indicates a substrate. Okay, and B portion indicates your deposited by some of the atoms. Okay, deposited area. This area is your deposited area. Okay, this area is deposited by your some of the material. Okay, how you can deposited? There are various kind of techniques, various kind of facilities, various kind of methods are available to deposit a atoms, to deposit a ions, or to deposit a molecules onto that particular substrate, which we will discuss step by step in our previous chapter or in our previous topics. Not previous, in our next topic or in our next lectures. Okay, so that this figure indicates this is your substrate. Okay, our substrate size is around centimeter or maybe millimeter or maybe micrometer size. Okay, or you can say that substrate is nothing but a whatever. If suppose this is your stapler, okay, this is the stapler, and we can say consider this is your substrate. This is the entire substrate. You can consider this is the entire substrate, and this is the surface of that particular substrate. Okay, and if we deposit onto that particular substrate of that particular surface, okay, if we deposited on the substrate of that particular surface of some kind of atoms, some kind of molecules, some kind of ions onto that surface, so there is some layer was happening. Okay, there is some layer was generated, or we can say that there is some kind of layer was formed, and that layer is in the form of thin layer. Okay, having some kind of thickness around 10 nanometer to 1 micrometer or 10 micrometer, and that layer is nothing but a thin layer, and due to that reason we are called a thin film for that particular portion. Getting my point? So that, look it here in third figure, look it into that particular third figure. So here the word of cohesion, and here the word of adhesion. What is mean by cohesion and what is mean by adhesion? Okay, the cohesion means what? The tendency of particular material. Okay, the tendency of atom, or we can say the tendency of particular material or object having the same kind of material, having the same kind of object, are attracts towards each other, or they are struck, or they are catch that particular material. Means cohesion means same, the tendency of ion or matter or object having the same kind of matter or same kind of object attracts with each other. Okay, you, for example, water molecule attracts with another water molecule. That is the cohesive force. That is the cohesive force. Getting my point? But in the second figure, indicate that the different kind of molecules or different kind of object attracts with each other, or they are catch to each other. Okay. Now here, that is nothing but a adhesive force, or that is nothing but a adhesion. If we consider this is the water molecule, this is your H2O. This is your H2O. Okay, this one, and this is your, you can say this is the copper molecule. Okay, so that this is the different molecule, and this one is the another different molecules. This is the water molecule, this is the copper molecule, but they are attracted with each other. That is, and this kind of force and this kind of tendency is nothing but adhesive. That is nothing but adhesion. Okay, so same phenomena or same tendency was also obtained or also present in case of thin film. Okay, because any kind of substrate you can use during the preparation of thin film depends on the application, or depends on our interest. Getting my point? We can use any kind of substrate as per our interest, and you can deposit your material, or you can deposit the ions or molecule onto that substrate. Okay, so if we consider a copper surface as a substrate, and if we deposit some kind of लिथियन आयन और नाइट्रोजन आयन और वी कैन से एल्युमिनियम आयन ऑन टू दैट कॉपर सरफेस. सो देर इज टू काइंड ऑफ एटम्स और टू काइंड ऑफ मटेरियल्स आर स्ट्रक और अटैच विथ ईच अदर, मीन्स दे आर कोलैप्स, मीन्स वी कैन से दैट एल्युमिनियम एटम कोलैप्स ऑन टू द सबस्ट्रेट ऑफ विच सबस्ट्रेट कॉपर सबस्ट्रेट. ओके एंड वट विल हैपन, दे आर स्ट्रक, दे आर स्टिक ऑन टू दैट सबस्ट्रेट. वी कैन से इन अवर मराठी वर्ड्स की तो सबस्ट्रेट वरती, कॉपर च्या सबस्ट्रेट वरती तो जो काही आहे ऍल्युमिनियम ऍटम की ऍल्युमिनियम आयन्स ते त्याच्यावरती चिपकतात अँड देर वॉज फॉर्म सम काइंड ऑफ लेअर. ओके अँड दॅट लेअर इज नथिंग बट ए थिन लेअर अँड दॅट लेअर अँड दॅट पर्टिक्युलर लेअर वी कॅन कॉल ए थिन फिल्म. ओके दॅट एंटायर सबस्ट्रेट प्लस थिन फिल्म. Okay, so we cannot call a substrate as a thin film. We only call a thin film to that those atoms or those ion was deposited onto that particular substrate. Ya substrate varti je ion deposit zalele astil tyalach apan thin film mhanto. Okay, so I hope that still this point you might be understand the concept of thin film. You might be understand the concept of substrate, the difference between the substrate and thin film. Okay, the you also understand the type of cohesion and adhesion. Okay.